Well, praise the Lord, everybody. My name is Kathy Ellis, and the name of this ministry is God's Power Surge, GPS for short, because I believe everyone needs direction in where they're going, and Jesus Christ is the only direction. He is the way and the truth and the life. Hallelujah. And we're going to start singing some older songs this evening, and we're going to be in Genesis chapter 11. And We discussed this in Sunday school Sunday morning, and I just had to share it with you. Praise God, because it is good what we're going to talk about this evening. And we're going to sing a few songs that I know. They're old and they're good, and just sing along with me. This is just a little talk with Jesus.
I once was lost in sin, but Jesus took me in. And then a little light from heaven filled my soul. It bathed my heart in love and wrote my name above. And just a little talk with Jesus made me whole. Now let us have a little talk with Jesus. Let us tell him all about our troubles. He will hear our faintest cry. He will answer by and by. Now when you feel a little prayer will turning, and you know burning, you will find a little talk with Jesus makes it bright. Sometimes my path seems drear without a ray of cheer, and then a cloud of doubt may hide the light of day. The mists of sin may rise and hide the starry skies, but just a little talk with Jesus clears the way. Now let us have a little talk with Jesus. Let us tell him all about our troubles. He will hear our faintest cry. He will answer by and by. Now when you feel a little prayer will turning, and you know a little fire is burning, you will find a little talk with Jesus makes it right. I may have doubts and fears, my eyes be filled with tears, but Jesus is a friend that watches day and night. To him in prayer, he knows my every care, and just a little talk with Jesus makes it right. Now let us have a little talk with Jesus. Let us tell him all about our troubles. He will hear our faintest cry. He will answer by and by. Now when you feel a little prayer will turning, and you know a little fire is burning, you will find a little talk with Jesus.
That's just praying, folks. Just talking like you do to a good old friend is prayer. You know, just lay it all out for God. He knows what's on your heart already. He's just waiting for you to come and talk with him. So have a little talk with Jesus. Steal away. Make a list of people to pray for. Make a list of circumstances. Write down your visions and things that you know that is important to you and things that God has given you, and pray over those things. And as we talked about last week, have faith. Hallelujah. Have faith. Praise God. Faith is very important. And you can't have faith without trust. I don't want to go too high. There we go. That's better.
'Tis so sweet to trust in Jesus, just to take him at his word, just to just Jesus. Oh, for faith to trust Him more. Yes, 'tis sweet to trust in Jesus, just from sin and self to cease. Just from Jesus simply taking
to really stand on faith and trust Jesus now more than ever, because I'm telling you, our eternity depends on it, and our eternity is closer than it was yesterday. Amen. We don't know if we're going to go by the way of the grave or if we're going to go by way of the rapture. We just don't know. But we have faith in knowing one thing, where our eternity's going to be and who our God is. Amen? You can have that no-so faith. And I hear so many people saying, well, I hope to make heaven my home. Don't hope, people. Know. Know about it. Make sure. Paul said, choose this day who you're going to serve. And that's what we have to do. We have to choose every day, when as soon as our feet hit the floor, who we're going to serve today. Thank Him for another day. Praise Him for another day. And say, Lord, what are we going to do today? Because this is the day that the Lord hath made, and I will rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. And we need to be glad in what the Lord has done. And in the church, as we come together as a corporate body, we need to really come together. Because you know what? As our body is together and we go together, as I walk, my whole body goes with me. That's the way the body of Christ should be. Amen. We should be going in one direction, and that is in the vision that God has given us. As a corporate body, your church has a vision and a direction it should go, given by God. And if you don't, then ask for it. He says, we learned last week, if you lack wisdom, ask. God gives it to liberally. Have corporate prayer as the church comes together and prays. Pray for the vision of the church. Pray for the revival in the church. Pray for the Lord to have His way in the church. Pray for outreach. Pray for things that, you know, and have a vision. That even though there may be different activities going on, it's all one body and it's all for the glory of God. Amen. And we're going to learn about working together as a corporate body, and how important it is. Very important. Very important. Because, you know, our victory Our victory depends on it. Hallelujah. Our victory depends on us and what we decide to do as a corporate body. And you know, the devil comes in to kill, steal, and destroy, and he tries to break up relationships, separate the church, and do all sorts of things. Know the tactic of the enemy and say, get thee hence, Satan. Because it says in the Word of God in Ephesians chapter 6, we don't fight against flesh and blood. But it's all the work of the enemy coming in to try to destroy relationship, destroy corporate body, to get the body in confusion, to get the body not functioning the way it should, so we can't do the will of God. So knowing the enemy's tactics, let us come together. Hallelujah. Because there's strength in numbers, number one. Strength in numbers. And you see that even in the animal kingdom. When the whole herd's running together, those animals have a hard time catching one. But oh, let one go. Oh, and they say, ooh, there you go. Let's get that one. Come on now. Think about it. We have victory when we stay single-eyed upon the Lord in corporate prayer, in corporate vision, as a body of Christ. One Lord, one baptism, one body. That's what Paul said. We are the body of Christ. Jesus is the head. And we are to look towards Jesus for our vision, for our direction of our body. Hallelujah. It's very important. And we're going to learn how important that is. But let us sing Victory in Jesus. Ha ha. Because He is our victory, folks.
I heard an old, old story, how the Savior came from glory, how He gave His life on Calvary to save a wretch like me. I heard about His healing, of His precious blood's atoning, and I repented of my sins and won the victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and He bought me with His redeeming blood. He loved me ere I knew Him, and all my love is due Him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing flood. I heard about His healing, of His cleansing power revealing, how He made the lame to walk again and caused the blind to see. And then I cried, dear Jesus, come and heal my broken spirit. And somehow Jesus came and brought to me the victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and He bought me with His redeeming blood. He loved me ere I knew Him, and all my love is due Him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing flood. Some sweet day I'll sing up there the song of victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and He bought me with His redeeming blood. He loved me ere I knew Him, and all my love is due Him. He plunged me to victory.
Now let us go to the Word. Praise the Lord. We are in Genesis this evening, the very beginning of the book. Hallelujah. And we're going to be in chapter 11 because this is exciting stuff, folks. And, you know, a lot of people don't want to read the Old Testament. But let me tell you, we learn a lot in the Old Testament because Jesus taught out of the Old Testament. Amen. And, you know, it's good to have this instruction because we find that people have not changed a whole lot. And a lot of things that's happened to Israel, we're seeing in America today because we forgot who God is. Amen. But we're in chapter 11 of Genesis. And this is exciting to me because we had talked about this one particular verse, oh, my, in Sunday school Sunday. And it thrilled me because the lesson was basically about a body coming together and working together and functioning together and how important that is, because the enemy has people backbiting, causing all sorts of strife within the church houses and just things going on that we need to learn to stand and say, Satan, get under our feet in the name of Jesus. Get thee hence, you know, and cast him out of these things and that he's trying to stir trouble to where the body can't function and move in agreement and go together. Hallelujah. But there's an importance in together. And we're going to read this today. And this is exciting stuff, people. Hallelujah. This is exciting stuff. So let's read. We're only going to do the first 9 verses here in chapter 11. And the whole earth was of one language and one speech. Now remember this. And it came to pass as they journeyed from the east that they found a plain in the land of Shinar, and they dwelt there. Okay. And they said to one another, go, let us make brick and burned them thoroughly, and they had brick for stone and slime that they made for mortar. Now, see, they're all working together, and they're making this brick and mortar. Now, what are they going to do with this brick and mortar that they're working together on? And then it said, go, let us build us a city and a tower whose top may reach unto heaven, and let us make us a name, lest we be scattered abroad upon the face of the whole earth. And the Lord came down to see the city and the tower which the children of men builded. He got curious. I wonder why. Let's read on. And the Lord said, behold, the people is one, and they have all one language. And this they began to do. And now nothing will be restrained from them which they have imagined to do. Did you hear that? Now nothing will be restrained from them which they have imagined to do. They all come together, working together for a single vision. They were making a city. They were making a tower that was going to go up to heaven. But first they made the brick, and then they had the mortar. And then they were all working together. One language, one people, working together. Come on. And then God said, oh, now nothing will be restrained from them which they have imagined to do. They would have built that tower clear up to heaven. Nothing could stop them. They were all working together. Now, when they work together, they're in one mind and one accord. He said nothing can restrain them. What should we be working as? We should be working one mind, one accord together. And nothing will restrain us from reaching the goals and the visions that God has given each individual church as part of the body. And as each church moves as part of the body in their vision, so will the church keep going and going and going and bringing more in. Oh, come on. Imagine. He says, what they imagine. Nothing will restrain them from doing what they imagine. And it was brought out in the lesson years ago about the Dick Tracy cartoon where he used to talk on his watch. Well, What do we do nowadays? People have these smartwatches, and they can talk. It's a phone, camera. They talk. It was imagined years ago, but we're doing it today. And there's all sorts of this electronic stuff that's going on in this artificial intelligence. People imagined this stuff, and so here it is today. On the Jetsons, I remember years ago in that cartoon where they used to talk on a TV screen back and forth. Well, what do we have today on our computers? We have meetings. It was imagined, but now we have it. And we, if we stop and think about it, there's many things that were imagined that now we have. It's the imagination. And we need to really consider the vision that and things that God wants us to do. He's wanting us to step out and do together, because we're stronger together and we move together. We help each other out. If one falls, we can pick them up. A cord is strong. A three cord that's braided together is strong. Can you imagine how much stronger a corporate body would be? That's why Satan has come to try to bring confusion and anger and jealousy and all those things within the church to keep us weakened, to where we can't move forward in the strength God had envisioned us to have. Think about it, people. Oh, this is some good stuff here now. Praise God. And it said, and the Lord said, behold, the people is one, and they have all one language, and this they begin to do. And now nothing will be restrained from them which they have imagined to do. They're all working together for a vision, and nothing will be restrained. And so he said in verse 7, go, let us down. Now, go to, let us go down and confound their language, that they may not understand one another's speech. So the Lord scattered them abroad and thence upon the face of all the earth, and they left off to build the city. Therefore, this is the name of it called Babel, because the Lord did there confound the language of all the earth, and from thence did the Lord scatter them abroad upon the face of all the earth. He said, I'm going to have to do something here, or these people are going to build this tower clear to heaven, because they're working together and there is nothing going to stop them. So I've got to do something. Wow. Isn't that awesome? We are one body, one baptism, one God. And yet we can't get the churches to come together for much of anything, because people's like, well, what denomination is it? And I'm sure God just sighs. We're one body, one baptism, one God. Don't worry about denomination. We're going to be together in heaven, aren't we? We need to come together as a corporate body, as a vision, because there's people dying of drug overdoses. There's people committing suicide. There's people that don't have a hope, that are homeless, that need help of a corporate body. Let us all come together, strength in numbers, to do something in our community, to show the love of Christ for the lost, the hopeless, the depressed and oppressed, those that are bound with addictions, Let them see the love of Christ. Let them see that there's strength in the body of Christ. And that there's hope and love. And that there's a difference. Oh, there's a change. They come here to help me because they love me. And they want me out of my addiction. And they want me out of my hopelessness. They came here to help me and to love me. And oh, I feel the presence of God. This is what I've been looking for. Can you imagine? Oh. Now nothing will be restrained from them which they have imagined to do. People, we need to come together as one body because we do have one God. We need to work together and love each other in the church and to cast that old lion devil out that's causing all this conflict and say, get thee hence, Satan, for you savorest not the things of God. We need to pray more. God, what is your vision? Help us come together as one corporate body. So we can make a difference in this dying world. Because there's so many lost. So many addicted. So many depressed. So many suicidal. So many sick. Oh. Come on, people. Imagine what we can do coming together. Hallelujah. Whoo, it's exciting. We're in exciting times when it's time to put aside and forget about denominational doctrine and come together as believers in the Lord Jesus Christ to make a difference in the lost and dying world because people need to see the love of God. People need to see that there is a difference and a change from what they are living in that to draw them in. Hallelujah. We just need to show love of God to these people and know that, yes, there is something better, something that they can grab a hold of and lean upon and build upon their faith as they come in to the fold. Amen? Oh, there's so much work for us to do. And we need to get together and we need to love one another. Hallelujah. For there's strength in numbers and we are one body. Hallelujah. And we need to do this thing. Praise God. Because it's important. Because everyone's family has been touched by addiction. Everyone's family has been touched by sickness. Everyone's family has been touched either by depression or suicide. Come on now. Everyone's family has been touched by the works of the enemy, and we need to come together as a corporate body to combat that enemy. Let us pray. Lord God, we thank you for the reading of your word to get the church excited, hallelujah, to get us to come together as one mind, one body, one spirit, one baptism, because you are our one God, Jesus, hallelujah. He is our head, hallelujah, and we are the body of Christ. Lord God, let us come together as the body of Christ. Let us do the things that you'd have us to do together because there is so much strength in numbers, and when we come together and work together, there is nothing that we can't do, hallelujah, for the body of Christ. Let us be in your will, Lord God. And let us have those visions, Lord God, that you would have us to do, have us to have to get us on the right course in the right direction. And we ask all this in Jesus' name. Still having the Thursday night services. The 28th of September will be the last one. And I hope that you come out because we are looking forward to seeing you. Hallelujah. And if you'd like to invite me to any function, then my number's at the end of the screen. Just give me a call, and we'll try to work out dates and where I can come and visit with you. And until next time, I hope you are blessed.